we are going to see about mycorrhizae. The symbiotic association between fungal mycelium and roots of plant is called mycorrhizae. The symbiotic association between fungal mycelium and roots of plant is called mycorrhizae. Then, in this relationship, the fungi absorb nutrition from the root. The fungi absorb nutrition from the root, and in turn, the hyphal network of mycorrhizae forming fungi helps the plant to absorb water and minerals, nutrients from the soil. The mycorrhizae are classified into three types. First one, ectomycorrhizae, endomycorrhizae, and ectendomycorrhizae. First one, ectomycorrhizae. The fungal mycelium forms a dense sheath around the root called mandrel. Then the hyphal network penetrates the intercellular spaces of the epidermis and cortex to form the cortic net. Then the hyphal network penetrates the intercellular spaces of the epidermis and cortex to form the cortic net. For example, Physolithus tinctorius. Second one, the endomycorrhizae. Endomycorrhizae means the inside. The hypha grows mainly inside the roots. They penetrate the outer cortical cells of the plant root. A small portion of the mycelium is found outside the root. This form is also called vesicular aspergillar mycorrhizae fungi, VAM. VAM means the vesicular aspergillar mycorrhizal fungi. Due to the presence of vesicles or aspergillus like Castoria, the three mycorrhizae are present. The aspergillar mycorrhizae, VAM, for example, Zygospora. Second one, ericoid mycorrhizae, for example, Oidiodendron. Third one, arcid mycorrhizae, for example, the Rhizoctonia. Then third one, ectendomycorrhizae. The fungi form both mandrel and also penetrate the cortical cells. Now see about TS of root showing mycorrhizae. The two type, endomycorrhizae and ectomycorrhizae. Ectomycorrhizae means, ecto means outside. The fungal mycelium, the forms a dense sheath around the root called mandrel. This hyphae network, penetrate the intercellular spaces of the epidermis and cortex to form the cortic net. This is called the ectomycorrhizae. Then second one, endomycorrhizae. Endo means the inside. The hypha grow mainly inside the root. They penetrate the outer cortical cells of the plant root. Then a small portion of the mycelium is found outside the root. This form is also is called the aspergillar mycorrhizae. Then VAM, aspergillar mycorrhizae. Vesicular aspergillar mycorrhizae are present in endomycorrhizae. Now see about importance of mycorrhizae. Mycorrhizae means symbiotic association between fungal mycelium and roots of the plant. Then importance of mycorrhizae: help to derive nutrition in monotrapa, sapropytic angiosperm. Monotrapa, sapropytic angiosperm. Second one, they improve the availability of minerals and water to the plants. Then they provide drought resistant to the plants. Then they protect roots of the higher plants from the attack of the plant pathogens. Now see about lichens. The lichens mean The symbiotic association between algae and fungi is called lichen. The symbiotic association between algae and fungi is called lichens. The algal partner is called phycopian or protopian. The algae partner is called phycopian or protopian. The fungal partner is called mycopian. Then algae provide the nutrition for fungal partner. Algae they provide the nutrition for fungal partner. In turn, fungi provide production. The fungi provide the production and also help to fix the thallus to the substratum through ricinae. The algae provide nutrition for fungal partner. In turn, fungi provide production and also help to fix the thallus to the substratum through ricinae. Then, asexual reproduction takes place through fragmentation, soridia and isidia. The fungi asexual reproduction takes place through fragmentation, soridia and isidia. Then, the phycopian reproduce by agenetes, homoconia, aplanospore, etc. Then, mycopians means the fungal partners undergo sexual reproduction and produce ascocarp. Then, the classification of fungi. The based on the habitats, lichens are classified into following types. Based on the habitat, lichens are classified into following types. First one, Carticoles. Carticoles, the fungi grow on bark. Second one, Lignicoles. The fungi grow on wood. Third one, Saxicoles. The fungi grow on rocks. Then, Pterycoles. The fungi grow on ground. Then, marine. Marines mean the seawater. The fungi grow on siliceous rock or sea. Last one, the freshwater. The fungi grow on the siliceous rock of freshwater. The fungi on the basis of morphology of the thallus, they are divided into four types. First one, lepros, crestos, folios, fructicos. First one, lepros means a distant fungal layer is absent. Second one, crestos. Crestos, the crest-like thallus present in crestos type. Third one, the folios. The folios mean the leaf-like structure present in the folios type. Last one, the fructicos, the branched pendulous shrub-like. The morphology of the thallus. First one, the crestos lichen. The crestos lichen, the crest-like thallus. Second one, the folios lichen, the leaf-like thallus present in folios lichen. Third one, the fructicos lichen, the fructicos lichen, the branched pendulous shrub like structure present. The distribution of algal cells differences lichen into two forms. First one, homeomerous and heteromerous. The homeomerous means the algal cells evenly distributed in the thallus. The homeo means the algal cells evenly distributed in the thallus. Heteromerous. Heteromerous means a distant layer of algae and fungi present. A distant layer of algae and fungi that present. Then, if the fungal partner of the lichen is called ascomycetes and ascolichen. Fungal partner of lichen belonging to is basidiomycetes. It is called basidiolichen. Then, the lichen secrete organic acid like oxalic acid. The lichen secrete organic acid like oxalic acid. The oxalic acid, the corrode the rock surface and help in weathering of rocks, thus acting as bioneer in xerocere. Then, the acinic acid the produced from lichens the antibiotic properties. The acinic acid the produced from lichen the show antibiotic the properties. Then the lichens are sensitive to air pollution. The lichens are sensitive to air pollution. Then especially to sulfur dioxide. Therefore, the lichens are considered as the pollution indicator. The lichens are considered as the pollution indicator. Then, the litmus paper. The litmus paper present in the dye present in litmus paper used as acid-base indicator in the laboratories is obtained from Rosella mandacne. The Rosella mandacne. Second one, Cladonia rangiferina. The Cladonia rangiferina is also called as reindeer moss. It is used as food for animals living in tundra regions.